Hello everyone, myself Narendra Vagmare, working as Assistant Professor in Dhirubhai Savant College of Engineering. Today I am delivering a lecture on topic Hydraulics and Pneumatics in final year subject. In which we are studying the unit number 4, Industrial Circuits. In which the mechanical circuit we are describing. Now, if you are there asking you a question on mechanical circuit, then the question will form the right ones. Your insane exam. And similarly, if you are good in this industrial circuit, or mechanical circuit, or circuit, so definitely in case of system design, they will ask you to design the system based on the flow control. Okay, this one just consider the cylinder. So this is the cylinder. Now, what output you want? The output you mean, so just consider here A and B are the two functions. Okay, A is the first point and B is the second point. If the C at this point, you have to perform some work. After that, again you have to go in the forward direction. So, for particular this much period, we require the slow motion. So that slow motion will not be actually directed by this cylinder. So for that purpose, you have to control the flow inside this cylinder. Because of that, it will control this actuating force. So for that, you have to use what flow control of DCVs. So it will be covered in part of the metering circuits. Because you are controlling the flow inside inlet to the cylinders. After that, performing this function, you want to go too fast. So your speed is increased here. Okay, if your speed is increased here, so from this position, just consider C to B, your speed is increased. So that time you are again using the another circuit. Okay, just consider that is a transverse and feed circuit. Okay, and then you will reach at point B. So A to C and C to D, there are two different circuits, which is a combining of one single operation. So for that purpose, you have to use the different types of the control valves, flow control valves, and DCVs. Now just consider the metering circuit. So what is our output made? Our output is a consist of the control the action of the actuator. Now the basic you already covered. Now just consider. This is the of TFM is for tank. Above tank there is a filter. F signifies filter. Above that there is a pump. Now this triangle inside this circle, which is a fully filled, so it signifies the system is a hydraulic. It is a empty, so it will be the pneumatic. In case of the 6 unit, they will confuse you by giving the triangle like this one and this one. So that time you have to remember this is for the hydraulics and this is for the pneumatics. So this is the basic things which you have to remember. Now above pump, we will supply that fluid to the what? DC. Actually I am going covering both topics of 4 and 6 units. Now here I am drawing the DCV, which is just considered the push button DCV.
Pillar operated
or the solenoid, this adiabatic. So it will be easy to perform the outlet function. Now in this case, so how it works actually, from the tank, the pump will suck the fluid, which will become the pump. So what is the function of filter? Filter will filter that fluid, impurity is present inside the fluid. Above, between the pump and the DCD, there is a PIM. This is the cylinder. So what is this? This is hollow shell. This is back body. So what is called as a return shell. Now, what we have to do? We have to control the flow which is coming inside the cylinder. Okay, so the thermal portion we have to control. So we are using the flow control valve at the inlet. So this is the, let's consider this is the in. Okay, simply we will so this is the flow control valve. That is what we call it as a MCV, flow control, and this is our check valve, CV. Now this is the for the inlet. Now the return end will be so this will be the return actually AB. This is the end check only. Okay. Now how it works? This CV and FCV are connected with parallel with each other. So this total system is a single equipment. So for that purpose we have to just dot it. So it will be simplified as a single system. Now, how it works? So when we start the button. So before that our DCV, our system has a position cut. This is called as a shutoff position. Means the total fluid is coming inside the pump. From the pump to the DCV, which will be directly supplied over the tank. Actually, at that tank position, there will be a connection between the two ports. That is P and T. Okay, so we start the pump. After that, the fluid will be filtered from the filter and filter pump. After that, the fluid will be coincided with DCV. Now, point number two, this is the push button of the DCV. So, when you press the button, so it will become at the position first. So, when it will become at position first, then what will happen? The fluid from this port, that is pressure port, this is actually called as a pressure. So, it will be connected with the P port. The from the C is arrow for P, the fluid will be going towards the A. This which line? This one. This is the A. This is the B. This is the B. This is the D. So, from A, it will become in this section. So, what is present here? At this point, this is a controller. So it is not possible to go in upward direction. Now Let's consider this is the position 1, or the fluid will be covered from the port P to A. Means this port to this port. Now A port is connected to what? Inlet to the cylinders. But the fluid will be covered at this position. So that fluid will be moving in upward direction. Now that fluid will also try to move from this direction also. But there is the restrictions because this is the check valve. If this check valve is a filler operated, that time it is possible for the fluid to go out from this place. But it is not filler operated, so it will not go out from this place. So definitely it will be go out from this FCV. Now see, this arrow signifies it will be variable flow control valve. So you can, by pressing the knob, adjusting the knob, you will control the flow of the fluid which is moving inside the cylinder. So the, depending upon this area reduction, you will control the flow so that that flow will be going to this portion. So this portion will be filled with the fluid. So the fluid has some energy, so that it will be passing some pressure. So pressure will not force our area. So definitely that much amount of pressure, it will get converted into the force. So definitely how much what the output you want, definitely that output will be easily gained. Now, when it will be covered this distance. So this is the central position A, and this is the A dash. Okay. So forward stroke is completed. Now the fluid which is present from the backward stroke, which is already present here. When you are considering in a hydraulic system, just consider one stroke is already happened. So the fluid of the previous stroke which is present here. Okay. So that fluid will be trying to move from this place. So that fluid will be going from this place. Connected to the B. So that B will be connected to the T, C here at this place. That B is connected to the T, so it will be going to the tank and it will be controlling the flow inside the cylinders. So this is for the metering. When you are, this is the first case, but after when your piston is at position A dash, that time you have to return this piston also. At original position, that time you have to change the position of DCV first to DCV second. So the fluid will be flow from now P to B. So this P to B will be fluid. Now that fluid will be come at this in this section. Okay, and it will be retract the piston to its original position. But similarly, here also some fluid is present, but that fluid will be gone from this place. Okay, now it will be come at these two portions. So you will be confused, it will fluid also have chance to go from this section and this section also. But the resistance offered by the control valve is less as compared to the FCV. So the fluid will be moved from the check valve and then again it will become to the A and A to T. So this is the for the metering circuit. Similarly, if we change the CV and FCV to at this place, so it will be the meter out circuit. So this is the metering and meter out circuit. The application for to control the system motion means if you are slow speed 30 meter per second, you will gain. If you are 20 meter per second, you will be by controlling the fluid flow. So this is all about the metering circuit. Thank you for watching my video.